Remember that each person has a unit level treatment effect or a unit level causal effect. And that's the difference between their potential outcome if they had the treatment minus their potential outcome if they didn't have the treatment. Okay? And the average treatment effect is just the average of all of these unit level causal effects. Take each person, look at their unit causal effect, and you take the average. Now, we can also define the conditional average treatment effect as the average for just some of those people. For example, the conditional average treatment effect for men, where you just look at the average unit causal effects for men, or the conditional average treatment effect for women, where you just look at the average for women. So over here, I have an example. In this population, there are four people, person 1, 2, 3, and 4. There are two men and two women. And here I've got their potential outcomes. So in this column, their outcome, if they got treated, this guy would have a 40, this guy a 20, this woman a 10, and this person a 30. Over here is their potential outcome if they don't get treated, 30, 20, 15, 30. Okay? So this first person, if he's treated, he gets 40. If he isn't treated, he gets 30. So his unit causal effect is 10, 40 minus 30. Okay. The second person gets 20 with treatment and 20 without treatment. Okay, so it actually doesn't matter whether they're treated or not. They have the same outcome. So their unit causal effect is 0, 20 minus 20. Third person gets 10 with treatment, 15 without. So their unit causal effect is minus 5, 10 minus 15. And finally, our last person has 30 with treatment and 30 without. So she also has a unit causal effect of 0. Okay? Now remember, later on, we're going to deal with the problem that in data, we never see both of these numbers for the same person. Because each person can only either get treated or not get treated. Okay? So one of these numbers will always be hidden for us, depending on whether these people are treated or not. That's called the fundamental problem of causal inference that I discussed earlier. And that's going to make it really difficult because we're not going to be able to see the unit causal effects from the data. Okay, and we're going to try to figure out how can we learn about these things when we have data that only shows us one of the numbers from these columns. Okay, but before we get to that, we just want to understand the kinds of numbers we can learn if we observe both of these columns. Okay, so one of those numbers is the average treatment effect, which is just the average of all these unit causal effects. So in this example, the average treatment effect is equal to the sum of these, 10 plus 0 plus minus 5 plus 0, divided by 4, because there are 4 people in the population that we're averaging over. Okay? So it's going to equal 10 minus 5 over 4, 5 over 4. That's our average treatment effect. Now, let's look at the conditional average treatment effect for men. This is the same thing as the average treatment effect, but only looking at the men in the population. So we throw out the women. Okay? So that's going to be 10 plus 0 divided by 2, because we have 2 people that we're averaging over. And that's going to be 10 over 2, or 5. So finally, let's look at the conditional average treatment effect for women, and that's going to be just like with men, we're going to look at the average only just the women and throw out the men. Okay, so that's going to be minus 5 plus 0 divided by 2 because there are 2 people. So that's going to be minus 5 over 2. So we see the average treatment effect is 5 over 4, positive. So usually we conclude treatment must be good. If we look at men, we see it's even bigger. So the treatment is very good for men, what we would say. For women, the conditional average treatment effect is negative. So we would say actually the treatment's bad for women. So what we see here, and also from the unit causal effects, is treatment effect heterogeneity. In this example, the treatment affects different people differently. This person benefits, this person is hurt, and both of these people, it doesn't matter whether they're treated or not. Okay? Now, when we go to the data, and later on in these modules, we're going to see how do we learn these numbers from real data. Here I computed it, but that's because I assumed I knew both columns. And we're not going to know both columns. So how do we learn these numbers? And there are a bunch of other kinds of averages you can take, and we'll talk about later on. For example, there's something called LATE, the local average treatment effect, and we will talk about this later, no pun intended. So those are average treatment effects and conditional average treatment effects.